What is up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. We're playing another indie horror game. This is one I found on Steam. This is called BU. It's a choice-based horror game, so your character is going to develop a personality based on the choices we make. It's about a year and a half old, but we're going to give it a shot anyway. So let's go. Spelling mistakes are not mistakes. They're little Easter eggs for you to find if you can find them. How dare you think I'm bad at typing? I wasn't diagnosed as the most dyslexic person the doctor had met. That is my complete slander. Today I'm feeling green. Green is so much fun. The color of life. A warm spring day. So calming. Filled with the siren's call of nature. But under the surface there is so much rot. An infected cut. The eerie pallor on someone's face as they throw up. What we think of as the color of poison, a radioactive meltdown. Nearly every Disney villain is enshrined in green when their big number comes. Contradiction, life and death, growth and decay. That's why green's so fun. So that's how I'm feeling today. Green, how are you feeling? Well, I'm alright. Let's go with blue. What do you prefer, day, dusk, or midnight? I'm a day person. What's your favorite book? Books are for nerds. All that cool. Kids play Vibo games. What? All that cool. All the cool. I can save the world, find true love, visit lands of an unimaginable beauty and wonder. But in the end, it's all just ones and zeros. Neo. What gender are you? I'm a dude. Yeah, Lewis is too lazy to draw a baby and a girl character model. Or am I just making a profound statement about how gender doesn't matter and we're all the same? Deep. Deep. Right here. Wait a second. I really should have just said that and not the lazy thing. Lewis, remember to go back and edit this out. Be you. You see a young person standing in their bedroom. Today is their 12th birthday, and this will be the most important day of their life. I don't know about that. I don't know about that. You're wondering about what present your dad will get you this year. Last year you asked for a pet. Clearly I got one. Nothing. You love Mr. Fluffy Whiskers. I mean, his name is technically Jeff, but you'll always call him Mr. Fluffy Whiskers. You love to hug and stroke him. Admittedly, Jeff doesn't feel the same. Judging by the amount of scratches all over your face and arms, but you love him all the same. One day, he'll accept your love, and it will be sweet. How about some cereal to start the day? Gingerbread Man the cereal? All natural? Extreme nummy nuts with totally radical surprise. I mean, does it matter? Let's go crazy. This is your favorite cereal, mainly because the surprise is there's absolutely no cereal in it. It's all marshmallows. It turned out those boxes of cereal they used to put a single toy in as a surprise ended up selling so well that they just replaced all the cereal with toys. So they're so cool, they're not held back by your trivial ideas of what is and isn't edible. Truly some of the greatest thinkers of our lifetime made this and dined on toys for breakfast. You may be starving, but at least you have a ton of new plastic friends to complain about it with. A parcel is delivered. Your enemies are always whispering in the shadows trying to get you, but you're one step ahead. That accelerated quickly. You always make sure to repeatedly stab any post delivered to you in case there are poison spiders hiding inside. You can't be too careful. Well, can't be too careful. One time I found a bomb. But the person who made it was smart. I didn't know which wire to cut because they made them all red, so closely interwoven. Dad said it was just a red jumper that your gran had knitted, but you know the truth. Alas, nobody's coming to your birthday party. I'm sure there's some tragic reason for it, but in truth, Lewis is a lazy piece of trash. You can't be bothered to draw that many people. no one's coming. It's not like you didn't expect that. The strange parcel appears to open up by itself as if otherworldly ghostly hands were attempting to reveal what's inside. You have a creeping feeling up your spine, a mixture of fear and confusion, and then your legs start to walk towards the parcel. You didn't tell them to. You flail your arms around in surprise, attempting to grab something to halt your progress. But there's nothing. You continue to walk forward like a wind-up toy till you're next to the package. You look down into it and only see a black abyss, and unceremoniously you begin to tumble forward into that endless precipice. The darkness all around feels suffocating, and then you're here. You don't know what here is, but you're definitely here. Oh my god, a magical adventure. I've gone insane. What the hell? What the fuck? 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 Screw you, Lewis. I don't care if your game gets a higher age rating because you've sworn too much. The only question I have, the single thought what my whole life has been leading up to, the culmination of my very mind and soul, and this single moment can only be summed up as what the fuck? Off in the distance you hear a noise, a faint whimper. You go over to investigate. Wait a second. You shouldn't have, like, a bunch of options and stuff? Facing the player to investigate the thing with no options of whether to do it or not seems to defeat the purpose of the game. Sorry, I really should have thought of that. Here are your options. Investigate the crime scene? Well, investigate the crime scene. Now you're out of your... Now, out of your own free will, you've decided to go investigate the crime thing. My own free will. More like lack of options. God, freedom of choice is so much fun. You find a strange sobbing creature. Console it. Kick it and scream avocados. Inspect the creature more closely. Seems like the reasonable thing to do. You can't say much for its fashion sense. Not because it has bad fashion sense. It's just not wearing any clothes. It's butt-ass naked. I mean, the flowers in its hair are pretty on fleek. Oh, come on, game. Did you really throw that in there? But the whole one-eye thing is going to make wearing these black action hero glasses really hard. Such a terrible fate to be involved in such cruelness. But wait a second. You could design a custom-made parry. One for one eye instead of two. Hell yeah! There's no need to cry. You could still wear action hero glasses too, we just need some custom made ones. After the darkness comes a noise, a strange chirping, like songbirds got stuck in a church organ. A strange creature begins to frantically back away, dragging itself across the ground with its hands. Its bottom half is uselessly trailing behind it, like the end of some grotesque slug. Run, fight, or scream. Let's fight it. Nobody can possibly defeat you in a battle. A rap battle, that is. Method Man. Look here. We have a piece of shit. I must admit it stinks a bit. Come on, why don't you quit? Just admit, I'm better than you and you can never hope to fit. Then it punches you in the face. Then repeats. That was one of the spelling. Look on the bright side. You're so annoying, you have all the nightmare's attention. That poor little creature with flowers in its hair managed to get away. You wish you could say the same about yourself. Darkness consumes you. You float in darkness. There is nothing. Not the breeze on your skin. Not the echo of far-off laughter. Not even the beating of a heart. But then, swimming out of the emptiness, comes a small flame. You are awake. You appear to be sitting next to a table. A small cake in front of you. You hear muffled words. Sorry it took so long for me to make the cake. Someone came round and I was a tad occupied. You must have dozed off while you were waiting. You hear these words, but somehow the words feel jumbled, faded. Your mind is rushing with the sheer insanity you just underwent. Was it a dream? If so, that's a massive cop-out. I mean, the worst writing convention the world's ever seen, but was it a dream? Da da da. I guess if Lewis can ever be bothered to make a sequel, you might find out. Suddenly, that faded voice comes back into focus. I'm sorry for keeping you waiting, but can you please blow the candle out? been staring into the middle distance for like 12 minutes, and I do have company to attend to, you know. You look at the glimmering flame, and you wonder if anything you've just experienced matters. If in the future you will look back with pride or fear, or have simply forgotten, you breathe deeply and then, blowing sound effect, what will you be 20 years into the future? You become the chillest musician to ever live. Your soft vaporwave inspired beats spread across the world, eventually bringing to an end all world conflict. People can't be bothered to fight because they are too chilled out by your music. You become a pioneering engine astronaut, legalizing super vapes that get you so high. They can literally transport you out of the Earth's atmosphere and into another galaxy. The hole in the ozone layer is completely blacked out by the steam cloud, resulting from an entire civilization vaping at once, putting an end to skin cancer. Eventually, you create music so chilled it even stops atoms from moving, preemptively creating the heat death of the universe, but it's cold. This game is dedicated to the memory of Ed Gould and John Bain. If you enjoyed this game, please consider donating to your favorite cancer charity, Lewis. Well, that was weird. That was fun. I liked it. I enjoyed it. The ending. A huge vapor cloud blocks in the ozone and nobody gets skin cancer. Really good. I applaud that. That was awesome. It's free to play on Steam. Down in the description, I'll leave a download link for it. If you enjoyed it, give it a try. If you enjoyed the video, leave a comment, subscribe, and a like. It's really appreciated. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Take it easy.